this session. Let me congratulate you for choosing corporate sector as your choice of profession. A speaker, you must be reading everywhere that, you know, India is the fifth largest economy, $3.2 billion, in terms of GDP, $3.2 trillion. And there are forecasts that between 20 and 25, we are likely to become the third largest or $7 trillion dollar economy. And many speakers after speakers before this have been pointed out that you have made an excellent choice and therefore you have nothing to worry about and you'll be having excellent careers. After having chosen a career, I'd like to congratulate you on choice of a B-school. And this is not just a ritualistic statement. You know, there are almost, I don't know how many of you know, there are 3,000 to 4,000 all legitimate AICT approved B-schools in India. And the fact that you have chosen first time out has been a very, very excellent choice. I'd just like to spend a minute on this for you all. I've been interviewing you all for several of you for the last few months. And among the other things that you say, among the many things that you say for first time, the choice is faculty being from IIT, IIMs, the ROI, whatever it means to you, though I know, of course, I have an idea of what you mean, and placements, which is all very well, which is exceptionally correct. But in all this, I see one point not coming through. In a way, it's natural because you've not been made aware of it. And I'd like to take a minute to apprise you of this very, very fundamental point about first-timer. We at first-timer know the heights to which institutes can rise if you devote yourself entirely for your cause. The heights to which people can rise if we devote entirely ourselves to a cause. Let me elaborate upon this a bit. You all must be knowing that management came to India somewhere in the early 60s and started gathering momentum by mid-60s. IIM was set in 61. And at that point of time, when there was not enough matter, there were a lot of people who forsake, gave up their career in attractive jobs in US, came to come back to India and further the course of management education. Similarly, a lot of people from corporate sector left their cushy jobs and shifted over to academics to further the course of management education. At that point of time, which was about 71, 73, we in First Timer have seen this from very close quarters, and we in First Timer have had a first-hand experience with this, and it is a very basic, fundamental commitment to pay back to the society. So you must know this basic guiding belief of ours above everything else that we pay back to the society. You know, fact remains that no matter how many seats IIM has, only that much number will get in. And there are many, many more deserving people. So to keep in that, we give you the IIM ethos. So please don't forget this defining value of first-timer, pay back to the society, the rich things that we got from the society. Before going on to the case method, by the way, it didn't strike me, I should have said it earlier. So please bear with me. Today, unlike other sessions, we'll be discussing a case. Earlier sessions were unidirectional, which is perfect law, right? They were structured that way. There was a talk, and then at the end of which, there were questions, but this is basically and fundamentally different. This is a case, and the case depends entirely on the class driving it, on the class participation. So when we go over the case, please do not put your remarks in the chat box. just as you did in a couple of sessions ago, in the chairman session, please go to raise your hand. You will be unmuted. Come in, make your point, discuss, question, review, etc. And that is how the case goes on. Raise is different. Do not go to chat. You can put your question in the chat box for being answered towards the end. But do not put your comments and discussion in the chat box. That won't work. Before we go on to the case analysis, I just like to spend a few minutes on discussing the present times. Because the present times are a little uncertain. These things will always happen. We have China, and then we have TikTok, we banned them, and then we have COVID, and so many things are happening. So my point is, yes, these things happen, but for God's sake, do not be so overwrought. Do not be so overwhelmed. Do not be so tied down with them that you virtually immobilize yourself, you know, ki mera kya hoga, saal waste ho gaya, all those things. That is absolute negativity. And then the result of that, what happens is, we get tied down in our immediate thing and we miss the bigger picture on which learning lies. I just, to prove this point, I just like to invite your attention to a very famous quote, and we'll see when it was sent. I'll just start the screen sharing and show you a particular. I would just like you to just go through this quote. It was written 160 years ago in 1859. It's the first page of a very famous book called Tale of Two Cities by Charles Dickens. Just read that. It was the best of times. It was the worst of times. It was the age of wisdom. It was the age of foolishness. It was the epoch of belief. It was the epoch of incredulity. It was the season of light. It was the season of darkness. It was the spring and hope. It was the winter of despair. If you reflect upon what was written 160 years ago, it pertains to French Revolution, by the way, but it was written in 1859. If you just reflect this, if each of this is applicable today. The point of these things happening, they are endemic. And so let's not be too overawed. Remember one thing. The COVID is not the issue. The most important thing is your reaction to COVID. Well, there's a huge big debate and there's tons of literature. And you actually remember one thing. Nobody can ever take away from you your power of reaction. How should you react to a situation? Nobody can take away from you. If I had more time, I would have discussed this. So if you're up, if you are up, and your reaction is what will determine everything. If you are positive that you will emerge triumphant, you will emerge triumphant. If you despair and say, mera kya hoga, ab kya hoga, and all those things, then you will end up in despair. Remember, you are nothing but your thoughts. And as Vivekananda said, your thought is a closed circuit. Whatever you think will come back to you. They're very fascinating field, but we're not going to that into here. This is just an aside to tell you that there is nothing to despair. If you decide that you will emerge triumphant, you will enter triumphant. Now, before going on to the case, I'm going to show you for next few minutes some names, some brand names. Remember, and we'll see why. Remember, the brands that you're going to see, about 25 to 30 of them, were all very powerful brands in their time, and no one could have thought that one day they will disappear. In the brand names that you see, I'll be very surprised and pleasantly surprised if you can spot one or two names. you'll be surprised, even your parents, your mummy, papa, may be able to spot only some of them. But your grandparents, dada, dadi, nana, nani, will certainly spot more of them. Okay? So big learning. And also, by the way, let me give you a tip. You can, if you like, go to Google and check out these names. And you would have lost a wonderful opportunity to learn. Please write down, I'll be flashing the names for about 7 to 10 seconds. Please jot down the name. And if you are living at home with your parents, go and ask them. If not, and see the reaction, their body language, their facial expressions. What did the name evoke in them? And I can teach you more about brand management than anything else. Okay? So we'll go through this for a short while, write down the names, and then we'll go over to our case. The first thing is Afghan snow. I don't know what it was about snow in Afghan that made it so popular, but this was a very popular brand, Afghan snow. Okay? McLean's. Maybe it had to do something with being lean and slim. Pata nahi kya tha. But yes, it was a very major brand. Moti, I don't know if it has to do with being somebody, a fat woman, Moti, or it was some pearls or something. God alone knows. But yes, it was a very powerful brand. Kevinters. Okay. Benaka. Your parents maybe tell you that there used to be on Wednesdays at 8 to 9 a major program of songs sponsored by this product called Benaka Geet Mala. Check with them, sir, when you go back to 7 o'clock, Benaka, kya hoti thi? And you watch their reactions. Amrit, Dharag, no. By the way, this product is still there on chemist shelf. I see it occasionally, but it's certainly not what it was earlier. Erasmic, Charminar, Lal Imli. Lal Imli, Neeli Imli, Peeli Imli, God alone knows, but what was it? Evening in Paris. Some of you would be thinking it was that old Shammi Kapoor, Sharmila Tagore, me a movie. Sorry, hate to disappoint you, it was nothing like that. Okay? Binny's. All of you must be thinking about Binny's chip and that very popular jingle, Humko Binny's Mangta. No go, it's wrong number. Binny's was something else. Dhariwal. Oh, it's a town between Amritsar and Pathankot. Still there. But what made this town All India brand which went on and on? Yes, your grandparents, your fathers will not be able to tell you this. Your nana, nani, dada, dadi will tell you. Canter ID is a bit of a tongue twister. I gave up on this. Sunlight, moonlight, starlight, God alone knows what it was. Dhada, pata nahi. Postman, how can a Dakia become so famous? But he did. Well done, Shabash. Well done. Kya tha? God alone knows. Vimzim. Yes, there was a very famous song of Muhammad Rafi. It comes on everybody's lip when they hear the word Vimzim. But it has nothing to do with that. And what was this Illustrated Weekly of India? I hope you know, Stardust, Moondust, Nightdust, whatever it was. Very powerful brands of the time. Himalayan bouquet. Some flowers from Himalaya, what it was, pata nahi. Grill cream. Thrill. I don't know what it was and what it thrilled, but naam thrill tha. Avis. Castofine. Vimal. Ovaltine. Astro, Murphy, Uniclone. There are about 30 odd names. None of them are there, but by the way, talking about brands, would any of you can guess the age of two very popular brands that you still see on the shelves? How old do you think Sunlight, I beg your pardon, how old is Lifebuoy is? And Horlicks? When I ask this question in class, most of you say 30, 40 years because you yourself are in the early 20s. So you give a safe margin of 10 years and say 30, 40 years. Now let me give you a clue. Both Lifebuoy and Horlicks, the age is in triple digits. Yes, you heard it right. Triple digits, more than 100 years old. Horlicks is 140 years old. Lifebuoy is now about 120 to 25 years old. Let's continue. How is it that some brands seem to go on and on, and some brands, now let's see some companies or brands which are more than 100 years old. Times of India has been there since 1838. We can over 100 years old. Bombay Dyeing, 1879. Allahabad Bank, 1865. Tata Brand, 1868. Britannia still has so much of shelf space exporting, 1892 onwards. PNB, it comes for placements in many colleges, 1800 and something. Century Textiles, from 1897 onwards. Godrej, 1897. Shalimar Paints, from 1902. Canara Bank, from 1906. Now, what, just spend a minute on this, because this is the essence of marketing of any field. After all, these brands were also created by very competent managers who, and believe you me, when they were at the peak, nobody had ever thought that one day this was there. Can you think of life without cell phone? You've taken it for granted, you know it's going to stay there for God knows how many years. That's exactly the feeling the consumers have had about these brands. And yet, it just seems to have disappeared. And that's the first lesson of management, that you have to continuously upgrade your skill, take care of your personal growth, remain relevant, and as speakers after speakers in the earlier sessions have been pointing out, you have to adapt. All the things that you are going to learn out here, in the next 7 to 10, the rate of obsolescence of knowledge is so high, so fast, that whatever you're going to study out here, by the time you're 28, 30, next 10 years will become obsolete. So therefore, I'd like to just give you another quotation from Alvin Toffler, and please abide by it, which will sum up everything. The illiterate of 21st century will be not those who cannot read and write, but those who cannot learn, unlearn, and relearn. And that is what we are equipping you at First Timer. Not a bundle or package of knowledge which you think will help you for a lifetime, but the ability to learn and stand on your own feet and ensure continuous learning. This is what we're trying to impart to you as First Timer. Okay, now we stop sharing. We'll go to the case. By the way, you know that most of you have done marketing in your BBA. Most of you have done marketing in your BCom, etc. And I'm sure you must have had some exposure to case study. But never mind, we'll lay down the rules. A case, I'll take a minute to explain. A case is nothing but a business situation brought into classroom in form of a document, a few thousand words. I believe you me, we have documents of 5 pages and 10 exhibits. Okay, but today you have a very simple case. The case is with you. A framework has also been given. Oh, you're welcome to chuck it aside. That was just a suggested framework. You're welcome to check it aside. And so, in this case now, what should... And by the way, anyone who wants to come in, raise your hand. You'll be unmuted. Come and make your point. And defer, make your point, modify, reject, accept, differ with others, take on their points, anything that you like. There is no right answer. There is no right wrong answer. There is no such thing that such and such a point should be made, such and such a point should not be made. Nothing of that. It's just what you see in the situation, and more importantly, why. Just remember this. So the ball is now in your court. What should a big sound do? What should Mr. Bartle do? And if you were the CEO, what should be done?
I'm audible, sir.
Who's speaking?
Ashish Sharma, sir.
Yes, Ashish, you're very well. You're most welcome. Yes, make your point.
Good evening, sir.
The class, whatever you have to.
Sir, my point is, like, if Big Sound wants to make its product a brand, so they firstly, they have to focus on pricing strategy as well as on other strategies too. But the Big Sound is lacking here. Their main focus is only on pricing. So what they can do is, first of all, they can analyze the customers of the rural India, like why the people of rural India purchasing the cheaper products, because of their lack of purchasing power, or because of they don't have any good options available in the market, so they are purchasing the cheap product of the rocket company. Okay, after that, what the CTVs can do is they can make a brand strategy which cover all the good features with good pricing. And after that, the third step they can take is they can segment their market of rural India, like what the customer believe and what their purchasing power and what they are thinking. Okay, and after that, what they can do is they can clear their product in the mind of customer. Like, agar product clear hoga customer ke mind mein, to soch sakte hain ki unko product khareedna hai ki nahi. And okay. After that, they can get this.
Please go on, Ashish.
They can make a distribution channel. Okay, like agar unko product bechna hai to brick and mortar stores hai wahan se like unko sell karna hai ya like they can go on and on with the vans, like all these steps they can.
Oh, wonderful, Ashish. There's very good points that you made. Let's listen to some others before we think. Ashish has just suggested so many things to be done. How do others feel about it?
Hello.
Yes.
Good evening, sir. Sir, am I audible?
Please introduce yourself. You are Pratyusha?
I'm Kathy Sanath.
Please go ahead.
Yes, sir. So what Ashish has said, I agree with him. It's just that I want to add some more points. The Big Sound can go for product development by launching new products in the current market. Like it can go for washing machines, refrigerators. It will definitely increase its cost, but ultimately the revenue will also be increased.
I see.
Yes.
Please go on.
The Big Sound can also provide discounts.
Mm-hmm.
And it can also make its product available at the reasonable prices for the people of the market.
Okay.
What the impact of this? It will increase the revenue generation. The customer mm-hmm. base will become strong, and the market will definitely be expanded.
I see.
Market growth will be there.
Okay. So a lot of you have suggested that one thought is you should go to other products also. But can we pause for a minute and say, what exactly the color TV is the color TV? What is it, you know, what is the business of the company? Somebody said go for washing machines, etc. So what exactly does a color TV mean to the consumer? What business are we in? And what should a company do? Remember one thing. A consumer parts with money only when he feels he's getting more out of it, value or some more. So when you are, they want to buy their color TV, what exactly are they buying? What need are they satisfying? What does a color TV do? That's the only thing you're supposed to do out here. Think for yourselves. And there are no right or wrong answers.
Very good evening, sir. Am I audible?
Yes. Hayati speaking?
No, sir. This is Vanshika Sharma speaking.
Oh, yes, Vanshika. Please go on.
Sir, I believe if the company wants to maximize its profit and wants to expand its business operations, first of all, they should analyze the demographic features of their area which they are considering. For like in this case, they are considering to expand their market in rural areas. So it is very important. So that they should search out and they should collect data in regard to demographic features of the people living in rural area, and also collecting data in regard to their preferences, tastes and choices, so that they could actually know what the consumers they are targeting want. Fine. So accordingly, they should manufacture or they should make amendments in their product, in their color TVs, so that the customer finds value for their money when the product is released in the market. Plus, they should also make attractive and simple advertisements so that it is easy for people to get the idea what product they are going to buy in the market.
Okay, my judge, but the point is, man, you heard what the MD said? Cost, he's just talking about cost. What are we all doing? We have straight away jumped on to telling the company, this is the case method. Nothing wrong with what you've done, but have we started telling the company what ought to be done? Somebody said that, okay, let's go into washing machine. Another student said, hang on, we must go and study the consumer. So the point is, before we all go do that, and all that you're saying costs a lot of money. Don't forget, every decision, my business decision, there's a cost to it. In the first place, your boss, when you ask you for money, will ask you, what is your objective? Now, what would you like? And by the way, I don't think we've still explored what is the business of Big Sound. What need do they satisfy? If we are not clear on that, and we start going and testing for washing machine consumer behavior, we may be ending up spending a lot of money without knowing, or rather without having defined our objective. Oh, you don't have to accept a word of what I'm saying. Please, by all means, chop it to pieces. But it just occurred to me that after listening to some of my friends, that they have suggested a lot of things, but I don't know why. What objective, if any, would you set for Big Sound? Of course, you don't have to accept that who's the old crew speaking going on and on. What is the problem the company is facing? All of you are trying to find a solution. When you recommend something, all of you are trying to find a solution. Wonderful.
What? Yes, sir.
Yes, go on.
Yes, sir, this is Shubham Pandey. And before making any point, I would like to counter some points that has been made. Some people suggested that we should go for marketing research. Some people suggested that we should go for other home appliances. The first thing is, the Big Sound company is an entertainment industry, right? And second thing is, before making any such actions, we should also consider that the executive body is thinking whether they should enter in this market or not. The first question is whether we should engage ourselves in the rural area or not before making any marketing research or any establishing any distribution chain. We should make an analysis regarding whether we should start it or not. We should make analysis, would it be profitable or not? Which I get the answer, it would be if we get certain more information regarding the rural market. Like we have information that Rocket is the biggest, has the biggest market share in the rural market, right? but we don't know how much market share it does have. Because if it has the 55% share, let's say, let's just suppose it has 55% of the market in that entertainment industry, it is still leaves us for 45% of the market. Okay, so we have seen that Rocket has upgraded their plant, they have improved their quality and overhauled their sourcings. So that would also mean that they are going to incur more cost, which might result in higher expensive products. So there is a still good chance if we launch a product with the price range of 5500 to 6500, that is the number crunching done by the general manager and the manager. So it might be a possible that we do make profits out of it. As the other two companies that we have in that area, we don't have much information regarding them. But I am making an assumption that they don't have that much of a quality product. So we can sell our 14 inches CTV, Big Sound Electra. In that market, we can introduce it. But before doing so, we have to take into consideration and also analyze what Rocket has to offer in terms of product. Because whatever we have the information regarding, it's just that they have the biggest market share and they are going to offer a quality product. So we need to...
Good. The class is already examining a lot of issues, what has Rocket invested, etc., etc. My only thing is, before telling company what should the company use, can we clearly define the objective for Big Sound? That the objective for Big Sound, taking into account the 3 pages of case material, is this. Well, I'm delighted there are 100 people, there should be 100 objectives. But I'm getting a little uncomfortable that we have not talked about the objective, but we are going and saying what the company should be doing. And what something you suggest later on find doesn't match with the objective, a lot of money maybe goes down the drain.
This is Shubham again. Their objective is to gain profits and expand their market in the rural sector without diluting their brand in the urban locality.
So, I hope the class is listening. One person has so far suggested that Big Sound should capture some rural marketing without diluting their national equity. Or am I to accept that out of 100 person, only one person is thinking for the class? Others are not going to suggest any objective? Or if the class is happy, we move ahead with the objective. What should the class do then? If this is the objective class wants, wonderful. We have about 15-20 minutes left. Let's move ahead with this. But the case also says, I read the case last night, let me very skimpy look. The case says CTV doesn't seem to be a priority of rural market. Now what does that mean? Did you all notice that line in the case? CTV doesn't seem to be a priority for rural market. Or is that not important, or we can ignore what the data says that?
Hello.
Yes, please come in.
Am I audible?
Yes.
I'd like to point out some few points. Yes. First one is, if the CTV is looking to invest in the rural market, first thing he has to consider is if we want to make a mark on the rural area, that we have to see the consumers if they have a buying capacity, and according to that we can accordingly we can put the product in there. And next point is that the brand should never be built on price alone. Okay. as the case suggests that the upper management is concerned about the spending too much.
Okay.
The next point is that the goal should be identified properly and the vision should be very clear.
But that's what you're supposed to do. You're going to be hotshot MBAs advising the company. So please tell how should the goal be set and how should be absolutely clear. You're going to be a lakh per day consultants and you have to give very clear guidelines to the company. I was a little confused when I read the case. You see, in the meeting in office, Prakash, when he hears the price of 5,500 to 6,500, said that a profit margin will half. Okay? Then, responding to that, Manka says, I don't think there's any virtue in losing money. Now, I need your help in understanding this. Is profit margin being halved? You know, you have 10% margin becomes 5% margin. That is understandable. But Mankan is saying, is it virtually losing money? Is reduction in margin the same thing as losing money? I couldn't understand this point and said, somebody please help me to understand. And yet Shivani questioned him, but who says we have to lose money? So what is this? You know, is the top management, are they losing money? Are they making less money? Lower margins? What seems to be happening? Also, Mankar is scared that, you know, he's wondering that Rocket has invested 50 crores and he doesn't want to get in a price war. If a company has invested 50 crores in a business, chances are it wants to recoup the money and not lower the price. Of course, by lowering the price, you may sell more and make money to recover 50 crores. But if you invest money, chances are, and you upgraded your plant, you're going to perhaps give a higher price product. So what is this case method all about? How do you feel about case method? There's pin drop silence at the other end.
Sir, according to me, the objective of the Big Sound is to achieve profitability and growth. Besides this, the business objective is to continue its business. It means it wants to be stable in terms of customer satisfaction, credit worthiness. Because after all, the stable organization can easily handle the changing dynamics of markets.
Okay.
Yes, so according to these, the what my recommendations are, it should firstly focus on market development and then it will help the company to build its goodwill in the market. So then it can go for product development. So the game will become risk-free for the company and it will also help you fulfill its objective.
Bharati once said, you're perfectly all right, but whenever we are discussing a case, we have to base our convention on the case data. The case tells you what's happening in the rural market and something about the consumer behavior. Okay, what's happening to the consumer. Now, just for what understand, and therefore the company, some company, Rocket and all, have work to develop a particular product suited to the masses, and which is what Big Sound seems to be doing. But you just highlighted the issue as if the product development, are the products in the market, is the data suggesting that products in the markets are unsatisfactory, their consumers not accepting them, something has to be done about them. You don't have to accept a word of what I say. I'm just acting like a reflector. There is quite a difference between the present product in the market being, below par, and therefore product development to suit the market, and the existing products already in the market. And there's data on which product is there, the pricing, etc. Now we are running out of time. We are coming to close the class, and the class has to decide. You've got to be managers. You've got to take a decision and solve the problem for the company. What should the company do?
Yes, sir. Am I audible?
Yes. Yes, Prateek.
Sir, this is Anubhav Pratap.
Oh, sorry. Please, Anubhav, go on.
If I may put my opinion, sir, actually the company is trying to get into the rural area.
Yes.
They did a roadshow, and they know the features that rural area people want in their TV, particularly. But maybe the features they are giving are worth more than the pricing the other companies are providing for their TVs. So could it be possible they just look at the features that are important for them, put in those features, look at the pricing, if that is profitable, then get into the business. Because this is a brick and mortar business, not a plug-in and play business. So it involves a lot of infrastructure and money, transportation, warehouses, dealerships. So I don't think any company would come into a business and hope that they will get a profit in 1 to 2 years next year.
I see. So you are suggesting, Anubhav, that find out the features that a company is, the consumer is
consumers doing. Are. Yes, sir.
But the case seems to suggest that the modern technology is such that there's a wide array of features. Will the consumer be able to say, hang on, out of these 30 features that you showed me, I want 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
So, but actually, if they involve the 30 features into their TV, then they're not able to price particularly with their competitors. If they can't
do that, managers are supposed to do.
Yes,
you have to, the market is asking for features. The company says they want profitability. Mankat says, how can we do this? Are you going to be a hotshot MBA? This is what you have to solve.
Yes, sir.
Tell me one thing. Is this rural buyer? We've been talking about rural buyer. Is it uniform throughout, or there are types and types of buyers? Are you understanding my point? Can we say standardize the rural buyer of Kerala and say this is the rural buyer and this is what she wants? Or even in the rural buyer, there are several other types of buyers. Is the buyer absolutely uniform? Are all the buyers of Surf identical, Colgate identical?
Sir?
Yes.
Sure. I don't think the buyer is identical. There would be different people from different earning capacities, as I think no one has objected my insight regarding government regarding company's objective. So mm-hmm. I think that has been accepted. The second thing that we were talking about, that price war, right?
Mm-hmm.
So
fear
I don't
of
think
price
we
war.
Can
price
we would
war.
Get a
yes go
fear
on.
Of price war. I don't think we will get into any price war. Mm-hmm. And if they are selling their TV, let's just say for 5,000, right?
Mm-hmm.
We can avoid a price war by not offering our product at lower price, but price closer to the price what they are offering. Like, let's just say 5,500.
But then, Shubham, at that point, Manka said we are losing money, and Sunil Prakash said margins are halved.
Yeah, that is a vague statement, right? Because he wants to know whether we will sell enough number of product, so that we can recover our cost invested in selling those TVs and everything. I don't think we will lose any money given the information we have, because halving our profits, even then we have some profits. Right, so we just have to sell enough TVs. Okay. We have to get enough market share.
Okay, so you are saying that even if you have, it's not that you don't have any profits. You have some profits, even though lower one, and sell to make money. But
yeah.
Tell me, I was thinking, listening to you all, some ideas came to me. Now this seems to be a very jam-packed market. Three leading players are settled. What would you say, it's occurred to me while listening to you all, that if we went for TV above the present price range, say 9,000, I'm shooting off a figure. You went above this range. What would happen? And you gave them the, you know, the works. You gave them all the features which the present TVs don't have. And you said, hang on, I'll take more money from you, but I'm giving you something that nobody else is giving. All of you were giving ideas, so it just occurred to me, how would this proposal work? What did the class to say to this?
Okay.
You know, about 15, 20 years ago, the small car segment was overcome by jam-packed with Maruti 800, Alto, Santro, Matiz. Now there are advantages and disadvantages of going in a particular segment. The volume is there, but they are well-entrenched players. So to get a market share, you have to work one hell of a lot, and then you may or may not get. So what did Lancer Mitsubishi do? They came with Lancer at 7 lakhs. Are you understanding what I'm saying? If a particular, and here we have three leading players between 5,000, 6,000. So supposing somebody said, hang on, I'll give them something that these brands are not giving, but I'll charge 8,000. Mankar will be happy? Company is making money? Can your marketing team sell that? Or we also say, hang on, I'll take care of the upper end of the market. But for these players, there seems to be some volume, some potential in this market. I'll give them 6,000 and be happy with lower margins. At least I'll be there. Can we think of these things? We're running out of time. It's touching 6. We have barely 10, 12 minutes to go and so much more to be done. And no one talked about the local brands. They may not be making money, but the local brand selling support, and those people who are buying local brands are not looking for any sophisticated TV. Can we give them a very simple TV without any works at a lower price? So perhaps after listening to you all, I got this picture while I was listening to you all, that if we go above the existing brands at 9,000, 8,000, Mankad will be happy, we'll make money. If we go in this market, as Sunil Prakash has said, and you all have confirmed that our margins will be half, but we'll still make some money. And at the lower rate, Alibaba give them a very simple color TV, which the lower people are very happy. They don't want any band bar or tamasha. They'll be very happy with the simple thing. Mix and match, aisa kuch karke, can we do this thing? It's 6 o'clock. We have come to end of our session. If there are any questions in the chat box, there seems to be one. Now, we'll do some processing, because processing is the most important thing about case study. Okay? Now, in the last, all we began at 5:20, it's 40 minutes. What happened? What happened in 40 minutes? And therein your learning lies. And what we're talking about now is the crux of the learning, and you must get an insight into it. What happened in the last 40 minutes?
This side, Shreya Vesh.
Yes.
I would like to conclude the whole para.
Yes.
Actually, we were going through the case, which is named as stripped down color TVs, which is well known, well said. Because this company had organized 6-day roadshow in Cochin, in the state of Kerala.
Okay.
And from this, these road shows, one main critical thing that came out was that meeting with the fishermen.
And the conversation with the fishermen and the people, the managers over there from the company, concluded that they could make this, they could grow in the rural market by stripping down means shortening the features. You could understand with this, shortening the features of color TV, what they are giving in high market, in urban market, they could sort down few features which is mainly required by those rural areas, and they can sell that. So then after that, there won't be any half profit margin, because half profit is when they will sell all featured color television with the same
feature.
Okay, then their profit will be half. But if they'll short down the features, then definitely the margin will be compensated more than the half. So that is the whole strategy they could apply, because there are more competitors in the market. As you already added, that they are unorganized sector as well in the market. So the biggest competitor is not only Rocket. The biggest competitor we are not focusing on is our unorganized sector, who are selling their product in cheaper range and with cheaper or very light features. That is the only thing we could do is the sorting out the price and providing the color TVs with selective features. And this can only be done by doing few more road shows on the places where we want to grow.
Okay, so promotion is what Shreya is suggesting. Go more road shows.
No, sir,
more
road shows.
Okay.
I just want few more road shows so that we can conclude that what those urban market wants, what features actually they want.
Fine, Shreya. Got your point. Now we have very little time left. Did anyone notice, if you see the tape, I did not speak any knowledge of marketing. Did anyone notice that? I reacted to what you all are saying, and I reacted to what was case material, but I did not talk a word about marketing. Did anybody notice that? You can see the tape again. So what does that mean? Now start thinking. You're here only for thinking. And we're talking about a time period of 40 minutes, not few minutes here and there. It's 40 minutes since the discussion lasted, and 40 minutes is quite a time. Think. What happened? Sir did not say. I talked about case, of course, and I reacted to what you all are saying. But imparting knowledge of marketing, I did not say a word. And yet, so many people said so many things. What does that mean? Could it be, and I'm merely suggesting, that all this is already inside you? If I didn't prompt, you may have heard some case discussion in your BCom and BBAs. But if the faculty did not say anything about marketing, but kept acting as a reflector to what you said, and a lot of things came out, you heard on what your friend said, what does it mean? Could it be that all this is already inside you? Now I'd like to just show you some very interesting things. A short while ago, I said that all this, is it already inside you? I'd like to invite your attention to a saying by Khalil Gibran, a very famous poet. No man can reveal to you aught but what? Read it carefully, but that which is already half asleep in the dawning of your knowledge. And this is the I am ethos. Get this clear on the very first day before coming. This is already inside you. We, a good teacher, a good B school merely gets it out. It's an unwritten rule that nobody can teach you anything. A good teacher merely gets it out for you. Okay, so next question. How does it happen? Listen to this. If he is indeed wise, he does not bid you to enter a house of wisdom, but leads you to the threshold of your own mind. A good teacher never imposes or transfers his knowledge, but always takes it to your mind. Now, what happens in a case study? It's the first time, you may not. As you discuss a case, and you must have seen here, you come prepared to the class with a case. You have one perspective in mind. Okay? So now what happens is, you come to class, you begin discussing, you hear each other. Right? And as a result of that hearing, the earlier impression that you had, the earlier forces of mind that you had, begins getting transformed, and another awareness which was inside you already starts coming out. I could go and explain this process. Swami Vivekananda explains it beautifully, but I'm afraid we don't have the time. When we meet in class, we'll go into this. Remember, how does it happen? And because you go through it yourself, you have the ownership of it. I have not done finances. I did left college. I've been in a marketing job. But I can still talk on finance, and you won't know I'm not a finance person. Don't misunderstand me. I'm not showing off. I'm telling you what happens if you have the ownership of that. So what does this mean? Unless you take charge of yourself, then and then only you will have to move. I'm reminded of a line by a very famous Stanford professor, Jim Collins. In his book, How the Mighty Fall, Professor Jim Collins just makes a point that one afternoon he had a case study the way it here. One student raised a hand and said, "Sir, you're talking too much. Let us handle the case." And he said that perhaps was one of the best compliments he ever got. The class was saying, "We have learned enough to be on our own." So remember one, and in Western colleges, the faculty talks for 15% of the time. Okay, so in 75 minutes, the faculty should not be talking in 15 minutes. The more faculty talks, we are doing untold harm to you, blocking your own development, and this time, and this will reflect in your placements. The other students will seem to be more confident, etc., but you would have still be struggling, etc. So the most important thing is, while you are here, stay charge of yourself, start participating, and you will see the confidence that you beam out here. We are running out of time. I'll just say one more thing, and that is about your stay out here. We all begin, when we were in Ahmedabad, we all begin by a relationship of being student teacher. And I still remember, and after that, it gets transformed into a relationship of two equal adults. And if you ever see the interact come to alumni functions, you'll see the relationship of two friendly adults when they participate in alumni activities. So this is what we look forward to. And it is beautifully summed up by a very famous American author, Albert Camus. And this is what ultimately relationships at first timer are. Don't walk in front of me, I may not follow you. Don't walk behind me, I may not be lead. Walk beside me and just be my friend. So with this, welcome to first timer. Welcome to IMA Ethos, and welcome to a very exciting journey of self-discovery. Thank you for your time. Have a lovely weekend.
It was very nice of you to encourage young students. The purpose of this lesson was to encourage students, to encourage them to speak. And they should gather courage to come forward whatever they are feeling, they should be able to convey their message. And some of them were able to do that. It was really good. And the problem is, today I found only a little less than 10% of the students only contributed. Next time I want maximum number of students should contribute. It's not a problem. It was a first case analysis, when students don't know anything about the case, how to handle it. Without any proper knowledge, they were participating. They were telling you all the management phrases and the management statements, what they had already learned, whether they were opt or not, whether those were applicable or not, but they wanted to impress you, sir, and they said so many such phrases. It was rather okay, encouraging for students also, but I think in the future, when the course starts, you will give them a proper method how to analyze a case, and then the contribution of the students will be much higher and much fruitful also. Once again, thank you so much. You said in the last that what is the relation between a student and a teacher, and you put it in a proper way and a nice way, that student and teacher relation is a friend ship relation. And for my students, in this world, only two relations are important. One is your teacher, another is parents. These two relations try to correct you, but all other relations in the world will try to punish you. So consider your teachers and your parents as your well-wishers. Teachers are there always to guide them, guide you, and rather they will always be happy when you grow. And then if you grow and achieve much higher heights than your teachers, they will be feeling very happy. Sir, once again, on behalf of all the students and the faculty members who watched your lecture, thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. Now, students should stay back. Please give the feedback also.